Hi, everyone. Welcome to a new episode. Today's topic is crypto Twitter. And this video came to be thanks to many suggestions brought my way on my last live video. So today, I'm going to give you some pointers on people who I personally follow, because I think that there are some ways that you can use crypto Twitter to your advantage. And despite all of the toxic negativity that often occurs there, you can do it right and you can actually have it enhance your life. So a few different categories of people that I follow there include some traders, some market analysts, some that are good for enhancing your or reminding you of the Bitcoin philosophy. There's one person who's really good with game theory. And also you can't forget about the memes and keeping on top of the news. Also, for those of you who are wanting to learn more about living abroad or wealth planning, I got a guy on there for you. And lastly, you got to have some comedy. So we're going to finish up with a funny one. So let's get into it. So right off the bat, we have some traders to go over. And again, these are listed in not any particular order. So right off the bat, we have Donald, for those of you who are able to pick up on that duck figure. He's a trader. And here's a recent tweet of his that I liked. Somehow, a lot of people were surprised about losing money in alts while Bitcoin went on its run. When buying alts, you're selling your Bitcoin and you're buying an alt, essentially a Bitcoin short. So if you think shorting Bitcoin during an uptrend is a no-go, why are you buying alts? This one also kind of plays into another video I will be posting very soon, speaking about why altcoins oftentimes mirror the same price movements as Bitcoin. But anyway, this tweet is a good reminder for you of understanding the movements of alts and the movements of Bitcoin and why that happens and what you're ultimately doing when you make trades. Next up, we have Bob Lucas, who in my opinion is a pretty level-headed, long-term trader. He talks about, you know, more than just cryptocurrencies, but he has it seems to be some good insights. Again, anytime you're taking advice from a trader, take it with a big old grain of salt. No one is an oracle. No one has any magical ball, but you can at least understand, you know, their point of view and different indicators that they are looking for. So one recent tweet of his that I found to be helpful was this one, and it said, "Technical traders look like gods in a solid bull uptrend because just about everything appears to work." This tweet is pretty self-explanatory in that everyone looks like a genius in a bull market, so definitely keep that in mind. Lastly, for today's little section of traders that I'm deciding to speak about is Crypto Hustle. He posts a lot about, you know, trading crypto, of course, and some helpful stats. But here's one tweet I want to feature, and that was, he said, "Most crypto articles that discuss reasons for price movements should be disregarded as fluff pieces." That's a pretty deep thought. Deeper than it looks like, actually, is that is the fact that Bitcoin and cryptocurrencies are very new. And anyone who pretends to know why it's doing what it's doing, they're just trying to fill spaces with words, really, because no one really knows. If you're trying to go from historical data, the historical data set for Bitcoin is pretty shallow. So anyone who's trying to be an expert in this game, anyone who tries to play themselves off as an expert with like a certified price movement that is going to happen, the more confident they are in saying that, the more wary you should be of taking their advice. So next up, we're going to look at a couple different market analysts that I follow here on Twitter. The first one is Vijay Boyapati. He is the author of The Bullish Case for Bitcoin, and he also has some pretty interesting tweets. There's one thread in particular that I wanted to bring attention to, and that was his thoughts on the Bitcoin block reward halving and how, you know, everyone's trying to guess what that's going to do to the price of Bitcoin. A lot of people are assuming it's going to pump the price because that's what's happened historically. Although, just like I said before, historically is a pretty shallow data set to be looking back to. But this thread that he talks about is really interesting. It goes over the Bitcoin miners and the sell pressure that they often place on the market, how that will change with the Bitcoin halving. So it's a pretty interesting thread. But the first one of this thread says, "The Bitcoin block reward halving is less than a year away. How does a halving interact with Bitcoin's recurrent hype cycles? Is it the cause of Bitcoin bull markets? And what can we learn from past halvings?" So if you are interested in learning more about that, I will be including a link to this tweet and all of the other tweets that I am featuring specifically in this video down below in the video description. another overall market analyst that I like to cover today is Willy Wu. And he had one tweet that I want to talk about, and that was the use of Bitcoin and its energy. There's always been this story of Bitcoin as, you know, this energy-consuming monster, but fact is, a lot of the energy being consumed by Bitcoin miners are renewable sources because of the cost and they have to make it economic. So anyway, this thread that I'm featuring speaks about that. There's one in particular. It says, on climate change in China, 60 to 70% of all Bitcoin mining is in China. 80% of this is in the hydro-rich Sichuan province. Elsewhere, mining centers are dominated by renewables. In Iceland, it's 100% renewable energy. Quebec, it's 99.8% renewable energy. British Columbia, 98.4%. Norway, 98%. And Georgia, 81%. So pretty interesting to see those statistics being put up. All right, so now we're going to get into some Bitcoin maximalists, but also they are a great representation or reminders of the whole philosophy behind Bitcoin, why it was started, and also, you know, why the future is still so bright for this space. So for those of you who might be finding themselves in down in the dumps for whatever reason, maybe consider following Jameson Lopp for some insights. He's definitely an OG in this crypto space, a really famous cypherpunk. He's got some really strong thoughts on some things. So here is one tweet of his that I am a fan of, and that is, when you don't have conviction in your beliefs, everything is open to debate and cost-benefit analysis. Many decisions become simpler when you have solid principles by which you live. And that's just one little taste of some tweets you might get from him. Next up on this list of Bitcoin maximalist permabulls, if you want to call them, is Pomp. He's pretty famous for always saying how bullish he is on Bitcoin. He's on mainstream media a lot, on the news, talking about Bitcoin, defending it against the other pundits for fiat. So here's one tweet from him that I like, and that is, governments around the world are going to keep debasing their currencies by printing more money, while Bitcoin stays as scarce as it was designed to be. Which do you want to store your wealth in? And it's just another one of those handy dandy reminders of, you know, the core values of Bitcoin and why it will stand the test of time compared to fiat. Now, this one, Naval, is really a great account if you want to look more into game theory and philosophy, learning how to hone your own passions and create success out of that. This is a really good account. I actually really like his description under his name, Naval Present. There you go. So here's one tweet of his that I like, and that is, doctors won't make you healthy. Nutritionists won't make you slim. Teachers won't make you smart. Gurus won't make you calm. Mentors won't make you rich. Trainers won't make you fit. Ultimately, you have to take responsibility. Save yourself. There it goes. You all play a part in your own future. What future do you want to have, right? So now let's get into some other popular YouTubers who are great for keeping you on track of crypto news via Twitter. And also, of course, you got to love the memes. So first up, we have Box Mining. He's got, you know, a foot in the American markets and the Chinese markets. He's pretty knowledgeable in both of those fields. So here's a funny, I'm going to share the memes that these guys have because who doesn't like a good meme? This is one that I found of his that he posted that I really like. I'm not going to read it because that's silly. You guys can just check out the visual, but here's one. All right, next up we have Omar Bam, of course, crypto with Crypto's News, famous for giving you the crypto's news on a daily basis. Here's a funny meme of his that he shared regarding these recent letters that people were getting from the IRS in the United States. All right, now let's say that you've gotten your philosophy down, you've made trades accordingly, you made some smart trades, you're on top of the news, you managed to find some success in this space, and you have some wealth, and now you want to learn how to plan it wisely, how to live abroad, how to establish businesses abroad, if that's what you are into. And for that, I would definitely recommend following Andrew Henderson, or he's also known as Nomad Capitalist. He has a YouTube channel under that name as well. Here's one of his tweets that I like, and that is, on this day, when many successful people are handing half of their fortune over to be spent with impunity. I'm proud to donate a far lesser amount to charities in Armenia, India, Cambodia, and UK for a far larger impact. It's just a great reminder of, you know, you should be able to take control of your wealth. And if you have the ability to make smarter decisions on where you live, where your money is actually going, you should be able to take advantage of that. So there you go. Now we're going to finish this one up with the onion, because sometimes you just have to laugh at how ridiculous society has become. And, you know, you can never go wrong with including a little bit of humor in your life. So here's a funny story I found on the Onion. It says, the title of that article is "Guy on Bus Really Good at Whatever Phone Game That Is." And it's just really funny and stupid humor. But anyway, it's good to get a little mind break sometimes. So those are my recommendations for crypto Twitter. For those of you who maybe are new to the space, you want to know what's going on, I'd say that's a good starter kit. In the meantime, if there's other people you find valuable on Twitter, go ahead and leave it in the comments down below. Anyway, that's it for today's video. I will have another one coming out soon regarding why the price of altcoins often mirror exactly or very, very closely the same as Bitcoin. There's many different factors that get into that, but if you're interested in learning more about that, don't miss the next video coming out soon in the next couple days. So anyway, I'll see you then.